Doodle doo. Let me see if I can turn this around with one hand. Or not.
Okay. It's time to cook with our camp stove again. I'm going to do my split pea today. We're going to try the split pea soup. I'll show you whose it is here in a minute. I don't think it comes with any seasonings. I think it's just the carrots, onions, peas, that kind of stuff. There you can see right in there. It is. It's hard to see in the sun. So peas, carrots, onions, celery, that kind of stuff. I don't think there's any seasoning in it at all. So we might have to add vegetable broth in the end. We'll see. It's too powerful of a flame.
Never.
Let's bring it up in the shade. Much better. Lid on here so we keep our heat. And I'm gonna go get a regular spoon.
Right now I'm pulling the cab mounts out of this side of the truck. I got all but the core support out. And then I'm loosening all of them on the other side so I can tip the body and put a body lift on it.
Body lift?
Yeah.
So you got a little mess here.
Yeah, that cab mount didn't survive. That one.
Is that right there?
Yep. See, I did this lift just in time because much longer, because that's how big the whole boat used to be. And that's how much it wasted down from the rust. And these are supposed to be attached.
Oh yeah. That's supposed to be all one piece.
That's the...
Like a connected bushing.
Inside of that mount and the bolt, basically. Oh, yeah.
You thought it was going to snap off, didn't you?
Because this is a little more what they should look like.
Kind of.
Yeah, and this is how the bolt should look.
Body lift. Mm-hmm. So you're literally just lifting
these
the body.
We're going to go on top of the factory cab mounts, so it'll lift it up 3 inches.
Ah, okay.
And these are the brackets to move the bumpers so you don't have a gap.
So we don't have the funny looking gap.
Nope, there'll be no funny looking gap, front or rear, and it'll have the...
Those are the braces.
And the gaps will all be
for
covered.
The gaps.
So you won't be able to...
Okay then, so each corner gets two, or...?
Oh no, there's like six of these down each side.
Oh, that's... So there were three on each side? Three spaces that you pulled these rubber things out of?
Yeah, there's one...
Right where they're setting?
Three... Four, five, and the sixth one's in the front. Nope, and then there's two. One is over the wheel, and one's in the very back.
Okay.
All sides.
Clyde's going to finish that side.
Clyde, get out of there.
Are you even...
It's rust, dude. You don't need any. Trust me.
You need some minerals, yo.
I guess.
He's starving. Low on iron. Check these out. I'm gonna sell them on Craigslist. Somebody dropped them off to me in a pile of donation items that I dropped off. So I was like, I'll put them in the yard. I haven't decided if they're cute or creepy. We're getting a spoon so we can stir. Might as well bring my other soup, my other awesome soup spoon out with. Ooh, I could bring this one. This one's heavier though, I can't bring it camping. I'll get used to this one. If we have to stir in seasonings, I'm gonna we've always got Frank's Red Hots, of course. We always have that. This is what I would love to put in it, but I don't think they have a dry version of it that I can use. Otherwise, I would buy the dry version to take with me camping. But I'll find some sort of vegetable-based bouillon cubes. Take with me camping. Otherwise, it's just gonna be a little bit of salt and pepper, I guess. Oh, you know what? I always put onion powder on stuff. Harmony House vegan split pea soup, meat and dairy free. And on the back, we've got 1 cup of water for 1/4 cup of mix. Simmer 10-15 minutes or soak till soft. Season and enjoy. So, we've got dehydrated green split peas, onion, carrot, potato, and a little preservative. So, we're going to give this one a try. And this is the other one. We also got this one here. Because I cannot have tomatoes. This was a black bean chili mix. Harmony House again, vegan, vegetarian. And this is just black beans, soy, corn, onion, pepper, celery. So mostly just beans and corn, it looks like. And this is homestyle chili. Homestyle chili with beans. Makes half gallon, the whole thing. So I think I'll just shake it up and make little portions out of it. So we got our onions. See, I see steam. It shouldn't be burning yet. Get my spoon out. Nope, not burning yet. It's not even boiling. It's just getting hot. I do smell I do smell it cooking a little bit though. Yep, I got my windbreak. Yep, I just need a little chair.
Just like you're down by the river.
Mm-hmm. Kind of close. I'm by the scrapyard.
Scrapyard, the pool? Yeah.
Scrapyard and the river.
Yeah.
I guess.
It's over there.
Something's in my stinking cucumbers here. For that fella there. And then you got these wilty things right next to the healthy looking ones. I think I might have a stem borer in there somewhere. I just dripped a little neem on there yesterday. Something's eating them. And there's one right there. There's a little, I think it's four line bugs. I don't know if that is a stem borer itself. What's next?
I'm waiting for my headrest to cool down a little bit on my creeper that was in the sun.
Oh, that sucks.
And then I'm gonna loosen up these.
That's all?
That's it.
Simply remove.
Simply jack the body up from the frame. That's all.
Simply remove.
Taking the Suburban Body off the frame.
Simply reinstall.
Just reinstall. Easy peasy.
It is a beautiful day, isn't it, Clyde? Yeah.
That's your hiking dog?
That's my hiking dog right there. He's gonna sleep in the hammock with me. Pretty girl. Me and the pretty girl Bonnie do. Let's see. No drooling over the food. Yeah, you. Stick right into the siding. Bam! Not used to walking with something 4 feet wide. It's like this. It's like walking with this. Not watching where I'm going. Oh my goodness. Definitely gotta practice with one of these things. Gotta wash the Clyde off of my hands. You can't just stick your finger in your Clyde's ear and then back into your food.
here. Crunch pop. I'm just gonna sit here and cook dinner and work on that hobby. Let's give her a stupid little taste test. See how the water tastes? Flavor in that. So I think I'll put a little bit of pepper. A little onion powder, salt. Have to wait and see. I can see the onion start to. Huh?
That is not a stew.
Oh, well, I'm glad you found out while you're not underneath it.
Yeah, I got a little rust. Kick it. Not happy about it.
Mm-mm.
I'll figure out a different way.
There's gotta be another Jack hiding in there somewhere. Okay, check it. Looks like we got a little bit of a boil. Got some nice steam. Just make sure it doesn't stick. Pretty watery. Oh yeah, smelling good now. There we go. Got a nice rolling boil. Gonna let that go for like 15 minutes till it thickens up just a little bit more. Oh yeah, now we're looking like we're a little more hydrated. Yep, definitely looking more hydrated. Oh yeah, starting to break up a little bit. Smells wunderbar. A taste test. Very mild. It's got a very mild flavor to it with just a little salt, pepper, and onion in it. So we'll check back here as soon as it's done, about 10 minutes. Okay. I think we've thickened up on here as much as we can before we start to burn. Everything tastes like it's pretty well softened. I think we'll let her set for 10 minutes. Off the heat. Okay, got that shut off. So here's our finished product. Looks pretty good. It's a little thin. I did put a little extra water in it, but
I probably could have cooked it down further. But Eric is starving, so let's feed him. Then I'm gonna go get some water and make some chili.
Gonna start a fire again. We got split pea soup done. And we're gonna make chili.
Hold, please.
Mine?
I'll have a few bites, but yeah, you can eat it. I know you're starving.
I can eat.
You can eat. You're allowed.
You let me?
Yeah, I'll eat. You eat your
you.
Own food. Here you go.
Well, it's not very impressive when it's only one side, but.
Mmm.
Locks are on this side.
What's the name of this lift? Do you know?
It's Performance Accessories. It's the only ones I ever use.
Performance
Accessories. Body Lift.
3-inch body
complete.
Lift.
Front bumper brackets, rear bumper brackets, and gap guards. So when all this is done and I line it up and make it look right, you really have to know what you're looking at to even know there's a body lift.
Mm-hmm. You see that nice little bit of more space above the tire there?
3 inches.
Oh, yeah. I can tell.
Right
and then
now.
You're going to put the bigger tires on it, too?
Oh, yeah. I'm going to put the
Tahoe.
Tires off the Tahoe are going on it. And then I'm going to put a 6-inch on the Tahoe and put great big tires.
Big tires?
35,
38, great. Okay.
I'll bring a little ladder with me so you can get in and out of it.
Yes.
I'll be here for a couple of weeks. I like that. That's pretty good. That's just a little salt, pepper, onion powder.
Fair, that had to be salt, pepper, garlic, and onion in it somewhere.
I didn't put garlic in it just for you.
I'm surprised you're not chewing it over garlic while you're eating it.
Could be. Maybe I am. This would be wanted on a hot day, huh?
Yeah, hot soup. How do you let that be?
Okay, so as soon as that's gonna boil, as soon as that boils, we will put our chili in it. Instructions told you to take the cables off and you didn't have to?
The wiring harness down the other side. Most of these lifts, you just bend the brackets up, they're on from the factory, they'll clear. Just gotta watch it when you're picking it up.
And then what was the last part?
The brakes lines?
Well,
the brake lines. Couldn't get them out of the clips. I figured when I picked the body up, just a little, they pop right out. They popped right out all by themselves. No damage.
All right, then. Oh, that thing moved.
Oh, yeah. That's gonna... It's freed up. My steer shaft's not coming out the way I want it to, so... Grab it. Done. Remove it. I didn't want to move either, so just like the brake lines, I gave it just a little bit of force, too much, gave me some room to move around.
More finesse than force.
Yes, sometimes you need finesse over force.
Check it out. We got a rolling boil. It's getting a little bit soupier, a little bit thicker. See the beans starting to swell up, starting to break open a little bit. You can see a little bit, looks like celery perhaps. Maybe pieces of garlic or onion. Looks pretty good. Got a little kick to it, a little spicy, definitely got cumin in it. I like cumin. It's a little bitter. I might put a little brown sugar in it, personally, but I am the flavor princess, as Eric calls me. We'll see in the end. We'll see if I win and get brown sugar in it. Not safe for work. Eyes on the prize. So we just blew it out. Gonna let it stand for a little bit and thicken. They said it will thicken as it cools. It should thicken quite a bit as it cools. And then it will thicken more when I crunch up a bunch of crackers in it. Okay, let this cool. Wait, my wrap. Looks sexy. Did sexy. Wow. That's quite a bit higher.
Oh, I gotta get the running board to pop on this side. She's hanging up, she's trying to pick the whole truck up. And then I'll be able to fit the blocks in.
The running board is getting hung up, you said? Oh, I remember you said on the other side.
Yep, on the frame mount, cab mount there.
But you didn't have to take them off?
No, I'm just gonna punch a little hole in with a pry bar.
Where at?
In the back. You can see where the fiberglass is laying on the ground back here.
Okay.
I already punched some. You can see where the mount's trying to kind of claw through up top.
A little bit of asphalt hanging out in the crooks. Oh yeah, down under there. Okay.
There's blocks in the back. I got them in the grunt in the back. The middle's have a cup. This protective cup.
That'll actually be on some stays.
Oh, it moves.
Yep.
I was like...
I unbolted it because that stays with the frame.
Focus.
This goes with the body. So there'll be a little deal that goes in here that pulls this up.
Okay, there we go. So yeah, I was like, what the heck? That's not cool. That's not gonna work.
That'll all work just fine.
These little screws will come up. I want this focus.
This one ripped out, so I'll fix that. There's going to be little stands, little pipes and stuff.
From under.
Yeah, there's going to be stuff like this stuck into stuff.
Oh.
That's the hitch.
Yeah, I see.
Gotta take it all off to get the bumper.
Look, crusty. And they wanted you to remove this whole cable system?
Unlatch it all from the body and the back, and I think it got mixed up with the directions are kind of generic. I think some of the trucks you probably have to do that. I don't think you got to do it with everything. But
these
I like
kind
this.
Of tabs.
Yeah, a little lighter than that, okay. Actually. Lighter duty than that.
Right on.
the grab bag.
Parts is parts. Brackets to lower things. Steering stem. These are probably for the bumper. These are probably for the bumper. Yeah, that looks about right.
Fun. Alright, we have fun with that puzzle. And in here, I just whipped up a little cucumber, spinach. I had some provolone style almond cheese, I think a follow your heart style. So I got the follow your heart vegan ranch, a little bit of Frank's Red Hot, cucumber, and I put this in the toaster oven so it's a little bit crunchy. My little quick snack wrap while I'm waiting for the chili to cool. Got my brown sugar. That was a bit pungent. That chili had quite a pungent flavor. So, see if we can tone it down. Tone it down a little bit. Some brown sugar. Chickity check. Get thickened right up. Actually looks kind of greasy, like it's got meat in it already. Let's give it a bite. Give it a test. Beans are soft. A little bit of cayenne or something in there. Pretty good though, not bad. Alrighty, well, let's dish up some chili. All professional, you know. Okay. Get my little mighty's, my little mighty spoon, and prepare chili the proper way. The way I've always done it. Sharon Ollie might be here. That's pretty good with brown sugar on it. Okay. All right, y'all. Peace, love, plant some peace, plant some power.
Another one.
Eat some plants.
They always have the three. Yeah.
Peace out. Okay, enjoy some of this dehydrated stuff. Gonna take it on the camp trail.